Welcome back to Coffee Talk. I'm Debbie Crawford, and this is
Teena Drake.
We're here with some unique things today. We've had some phone calls and we've had some questions, so we're going to cover some of those. And we left off something a few times, and what was that that people have asked us?
People keep asking us about the National Month Day.
They love it.
They do. It was so fun. We apologize. Remember how we started it? We just thought this would be interesting for all of you that might be home, those of you that are shut-ins. And so now it's become fun. And
we're sorry we left it off. We didn't realize so many people enjoyed it, so now we're going to make sure it's always in there.
At least the highlights.
At least for the month and a couple of days, maybe.
Right.
And I think our first day is actually National Piano Music Classical.
Actually, September is the entire month. National Classical Music, National Piano, and National Honey Month.
Oh, wow.
So go out and support your local honey people, the distributors, and the beekeepers.
Oh, my. They do some cool stuff with the bees, you know?
Right.
But if we didn't have the bees, we wouldn't have peaches or apples or any fruit, because they actually pollinate it. So not only buying the honey helps the beekeeper, it also helps the local farmers, because without those bees, we wouldn't have that fruit.
Right.
So we need the bees and we need the honey.
We need the beekeepers.
Yeah.
And I couldn't do it.
We just get to eat the honey.
Right.
The bees. Yeah.
You want to try to get local honey. I just think this is interesting. But you want to try to get local honey. It actually helps with allergies.
It does, unless you're allergic to
honey.
The honey. Okay. I'm allergic to the honey.
Are you really?
I cannot eat honey. I stop breathing.
Okay. Don't do that.
But honey is good for allergies, unless you're allergic to the honey. I just messed that up for
Okay, here we go. It's okay. Moving on. The national month is, of course, classical music, piano, and honey. But some of the fun days in September are National Coffee Day. And with the Coffee Talk, the real Coffee Talk, we thought that would be fun. That's the end of September. You can look it up online.
Yeah.
As far as the day, I think that one was the 29th.
It is. It's the last.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, you get your regular coffee at the coffee shop all the time. Try something new.
Sure. You know? Put it on your calendar. Have a special coffee day.
Yeah.
That would be great. I love coffee.
I do, too. Now, see, we were talking about the National Orchestra and classical music thing, and Teena did not know about the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. So, and our technician guy didn't know about it either, so he's back behind the camera. And I let them listen to it, and it's really a neat orchestra, and it's in the community. I think it's in Indianapolis or Cincinnati once a year. You need to try to go see them. It's unusual. It's not your normal classical music, but boy, there's a surprise in there for you.
Oh, that was fun. And you get your ticket, so you can probably get them now, because you said they probably, maybe the tour time would be December.
Yeah, they're usually in around Christmas time, because that's their big time. So that's it's really.
I can't believe we're talking about Christmas.
Oh, well, it's close.
It is.
So
I mean, it's going to be here. Next month is Halloween, and then we move right into Thanksgiving.
That brings us another thing with packages and stuff. So,
oh, yes. So
I
spoke to our local postal workers, and I told you guys last time that they have helped me. They are doing a wonderful job. But we just wanted to make sure you knew, they want your packages.
Oh, they're ready
for you. They want the big, you know, Amazon packages, the big orders. The postal company is gearing up and preparing you and your Christmas presents.
Yeah.
And they want you to be as excited as they are to deliver them. So, you know, all we want you to do is make sure that you keep your areas to where you know where you can get your packages.
Right.
You know, if you some suggestions we've made is maybe a larger mailbox, and that was just to protect your stuff.
Yes, either that or, you know, wherever they have to leave it on the porch, find a secure way to do that.
Right.
You know, I have a friend that actually made a mailbox that can only the lid only opens down.
Oh, neat!
So once the package is in there, so the mailman puts the package in there for them, or the UPS guy. So if you can just figure out a secure way to keep your packages, it would help.
Be creative. You know, we're not trying to introduce anything to be negative into your life. We want you to have your packages, and we want you to be safe. And so, and also keep your postal workers safe. We love them.
Yeah, we do.
Really. Right now, they're keeping me busy.
they're helping her with a lot of things with her new business. So,
right.
And without them, she couldn't accomplish the things that she's doing with Live Love. So,
I love our postal workers. So, buy your packages and send them U.S. Postal. We're excited.
Yeah.
And all of our postal workers are, too.
And we appreciate them very much.
We do. We're moving on to our grandparents' corner. I can't take care of this, so I get to introduce it. Someday.
I never know what she's going to ask either.
Someday I will. Tell us a little bit about what is the greatest thing about being a grandparent.
Oh, my goodness. Just one? Do I have to pick just one?
Okay. We should probably limit her to five.
Okay.
But can they be five?
Yeah, I can maybe do it less than five. I think the most rewarding thing of being a grandparent is when you see your grandchildren listen to you and understand you. Now, I know this is, I'm sorry, Anastasia, when you're 16, you're going to hate this story, but I got to tell it. You know, little kids are always like wanting to, you know, do this or, you know, they run their hand and I'm just, that drives me crazy. And I always look at her and I say, excuse me, young ladies use a tissue. And you are a young lady, so what do you need to be doing? And well, she jumps down, she runs and gets a tissue, and now I don't have to say anything. She'll go, and she looks at me, and she goes and gets the tissue. But, you know, it's just one of those, and then she teaches Penelope. Penelope, you are a young lady, you have to use a tissue.
That is wonderful.
Yeah, it is. But then when you see the kids actually, they ask you questions and want your advice. Now, that's really good. And at 4 years old, that's great. But I know that's not going to happen when she's probably older. I hope it does. But, you know. But
I don't know. My Ashby calls, my Darian call, all of them. And even Nicholas, they call from all over places and call
to grandma.
Grandmother.
Yes. Oh, that's great.
They call Mima and they say, Mima. And I'll say, wait a minute. Why didn't you call me?
Well,
they just laugh. They think that's funny. But there are things that your grandparent can answer.
Right.
And, of course, I'm not going to get sentimental on you guys. But, of course, we have that connection. We understand that because my grandmother and her grandmother influenced our lives quite.
Very influential in our lives.
And very strong.
Another thing with being a grandparent that's very rewarding is the kids want to see you, you know, and they're excited when you show up. But I think just being able to be with this child and help them through things and then see them grow into the person that you hope they do is just really neat because you're not worried about where their doctor bills are going to be paid, how they're going to be paid, or where are you going to get the money to make sure there's dinner all week, or do you have to work overtime in order to make that house payment because there was a doctor's appointment. That's all gone. You're just focused on that child, and it's just different than your children.
It's focused on the fun.
Not just the fun. You're focused on the child. If they have an issue or a question, you can take time and answer that question. You're not worried about packing up for daycare tomorrow or getting the laundry done. I don't have to do all that.
Right.
Mom and Dad do.
Right.
So I can actually sit down and talk to the kids.
Mm-hmm.
And I can actually say, I don't have to do that. I can go do this. So
that's fun.
There's a big difference. I don't know. Just grandkids are just so different. That's not five, I know, but it's just
pretty close.
It's just really neat. It's just really neat to watch them grow.
That's amazing.
And mentally, you know, and read them. I get to sit down and read National Geographic with them, and their parents don't have time to do that.
Sure.
So we go all over the world in a book, you know, and they'll say, but I'm a girl. I don't care what you are. You got two hands, you got two feet, you can do whatever you want.
And there's something different about those moments with your grandparent, you know, even as an adult and even as those times have passed, you know. And like I said, I can't speak as far as being a grandparent, but I can say that the influence I have had as far as a person from my grandparent, and of course, my grandmother, my baba, and then, of course, on my dad's family side and all of the family coming together. So
I think we need to really remember that as a grandparent, we have more influence over those children, sometimes more than the parent.
You do.
So we need to be careful. You know, if we think something's okay in our realm as at our age, they may take it's okay at their age.
Right.
So we need to be really careful.
I always said that, you know, as a teacher, one of the things is that the children will always want to be like those people that are kind to them and loving and yes. caring. And grandparents kind of fill those right. roles. And I know one of the most harsh things that I had to deal with was when the grandparents had to raise their children, grandchildren.
And that is difficult.
But you know what? They did well because, again, right. they knew this was their responsibility, and they had to be the observe, you know, the child was going to observe how they acted
yes.
towards this. So,
yes.
And that's, I just think that's a great respect. I have a great respect yeah. for grandparents in general.
Well, that's what we were talking about before, respecting the mother and the father.
Right.
How we react to everything, those grandchildren are going to remember that.
Sure.
And if we react to mom and dad shouldn't have said that, well, then the kids, well, mom and dad shouldn't have said
right.
that. So you got to be careful because that's
as diplomatic as you can be.
I had one lady tell me one time that having children and grandchildren is like getting a brand new vase, and what you fill it with is what you have in the end.
Oh, that's
so
nice.
So if you fill it with dirt, you've got a vase full of dirt.
Oh, so what you seed and you plant, which is moving right on to live, love, but that's amazing.
Yes, so you got to remember what you're putting in that little vase is what's going to create that human being
Aww.
Later. So you got to be careful what you put in there.
Hmm. Well, you know, kids look up to other people, other adults. They really do.
Mm-hmm.
And the one thing I was getting ready to say, and I kind of got off track, but is kids do look up to their teachers and their grandparents.
Yeah.
And sometimes they say those things like, I want to be just like you. And it's not because they don't love their parents. It's because that's a different, you know, it's not.
Right.
How many people want, I mean, I know when I was growing up, people say, you look just like your mom. It's like, why do you say that? Because as a child, I was looking at my mom going, oh my goodness, she's old, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
No, you're not old. I know now, Mom.
Well,
I'm older. I get it.
But at 16, you don't want to look like you're 53.
Right. So when you look at your grandparent, you're not thinking of that.
No.
You know, you're thinking, I look up, I want to be just like that person.
Right.
So be the example. And you know, whether it's grandparent, if you're in that lead role, or if you're a teacher, or whoever you might be,
right.
that children have that possible expectation to be just like you.
Oh, yeah.
Just like you.
Now, through all this, we're talking about grandparents and parents and teachers. There's something that sometimes parents forget. There's your resource.
Right.
He won't clean his room. She won't make her bed or whatever. Stop arguing with them. You asked them once, twice, three times. You grant. Then you go to the, who does that child look up to? Go to that person and say, look, we really need to focus on this because they're not doing this. The grades are going down. Whatever it is, let that grandparent sit down and have cookies and ice cream with the kid and talk about, you know, well, so-and-so wasn't doing their homework and they didn't make it to the next grade. And, wow, all their friends went ahead of them, and that was kind of rough on him. You need to say hi to him next time you see him. Well, you didn't only just tell them that they need to do their homework. They need to be nice to the kid that forgot to do their homework.
Right.
But use those resources. Use those grandparents. Use the teacher. Whoever that child looks up to, go to them and say, we're having difficulty. We need to make sure he does his homework or she makes her bed or whatever. But use those resources.
Right.
And parents don't think about that. They think, we need to take care of it.
I thought my mother and my grandmother were my lifeline when I was raising my children. I'm going to tell you right now. They don't, you know, and I would tell my children, do you realize that your Meemaw and Baba would be so disappointed? You know, I'd get on the phone and just chat. And I would say, they would be so disappointed. And my kids would stop immediately.
They do.
Oh, I don't want Meemaw or Baba to be disappointed.
Right. I think there's just a natural thing in children to grow up and be independent from their parents. And that's just
cutting
normal.
Those apron strings.
Yeah. And the kids naturally want to grow up and separate from that adult figure. But they always want to stay connected to the grandparents and their teachers and stuff. So use them. Go tell Grandma that John's not doing whatever and Mary's not doing what, and then let it go. Let Grandma
and
take
let them
care
see
of it.
If they can work through it. Our next
and they
part,
do.
Yes, they do. Our next part is live love, and it's our love section, which is obviously my very favorite.
Yep.
But this is pretty interesting to me because I have been married for 25, almost 26 years now, and people keep asking me, how do I find true love? And I want to be in love, or I want a relationship. And through Sunshine Messages, I've actually had some people message me and ask me, please help me, you know, with a Sunshine Message. I want to find that perfect partner or whatever. Well, I'm going to take the word
perfect out.
Because unless you're perfect, it's going to be hard for me to believe that you're going to find a perfect match. Mm-hmm. However, I do have some quick tips just to help you find at least a new group, a friend, or maybe possibly love in the end.
Right.
So I want you to go and look at where you're looking.
That's
I had this lady that messaged me, and I'm not going to tell your name because I promised I wouldn't,
right.
But I did ask for permission
to tell
this story.
But it's a good example.
It is.
It's a good example.
And she was going out on Friday nights and Saturday nights, and she would call me on Sundays, and I need a Sunshine Message, and I was like, okay, you know. And it was continuously the same thing. She knows what I'm going to say. So I said, well, did you find anybody? Did you make new friends? No, I didn't. I was sick, or this happened, or this happened. Come to find out, this lady did not like to drink alcohol, but she was spending her Friday and Saturday nights at a bar looking for the perfect person that doesn't like to drink alcohol.
And you're not going to find them there.
Right. And people laugh, just like you do. Every time I give this message, I look at them and say, where are you looking for that perfect? So let's start with taking perfect out. Where are you looking for that person to have fun with? So here is my greatest suggestion. It's a Sunshine Message. Look where you have fun.
Yes.
My grandmother always told me, you cannot go out into the barn in the dark and find something. You have to have a light, whether it be a light you take with you or a light and you go in the daytime. It's the same thing. You're not going to find someone that enjoys doing what you're doing if you're not in that position. Okay?
You got to be there.
Right. For an example, if you love to travel, find a travel group. Find a travel blogger. Mm-hmm. I know that. I have another really good friend of mine. She is actually my success story right now. Gives me cold chills to talk about. But her message was, find more fun things to do.
Right.
And I talked to her like a week ago, and we did a vibrational reset and some Sunshine Messages. And you know what? She said, I don't even think about it anymore.
She just automatically does it.
She automatically only schedules things on her calendar that are fun.
Right.
So, for example, one of the things that she did was she came to a gig, and we were talking about that, and I said, you know, have you met anybody, you know, or is there love in the future? And she said, I haven't even thought about it ever since we started this.
She likes who she is and where she is.
Right.
It doesn't take another person to make you whole.
Right.
That would be your companion. That would be your, you just need another person sometimes to have as a companion.
Exactly.
And I think people look at it as somebody that makes them whole. You're already whole.
You are. You are already the most special.
Yeah.
You're a creation in the made of an image of God. So find things you love to do.
Right.
You know, I mean, I don't care what it is. Quit looking in the dark for a lot of light.
Yeah.
Be the light. And the more you shine, the more those people that love to do what you do. I do not want to sky jump. I do not want to jump from an airplane ever in my lifetime.
So you're not going to see her.
However, she does. So she would find people that were like-minded.
Yeah.
And that's all. It's a very simple process. It's not difficult. When you go out, if you're saying, man, I don't know if I want to wear this, or do I look like... No, stop. Better yet,
if it's
plan
a
trip.
Don't do it. Yeah.
Right. Plan a trip to go canoeing.
Yeah.
Take October and plan, you know, in this area,
if
that's what you like to do. In this area, there is a place, and I'm not advertising for him, but Two Rivers, I believe, is called in Carrollton. I read his story. It is amazing. And he talks about, you know, what he loved to do, and he came back to this area and opened this canoe company.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I love to canoe. I have not done it yet. I will report back when I do that. I've canoed, but I have not been over there to this young man. But I do want you to know that plan something fun, yes. and like-minded people will be there.
Yep.
I know one of my cousins reported on Facebook the other day that she went to her first youth rally, and that's where she was raised. She said, I felt so good. And I said, because you, that's where you felt good,
oh, yes.
you know, as a kid.
Right.
So find the fun in you, and the fun will come and find you. You know, the love, all will follow. So be happy where you're at right. right now, right now. Be happy where you're at right now, and then it'll keep going.
Yeah, and you can always share that. You know, there's places that need volunteers. The end of the month is, is it this weekend or next weekend that is Light White? It's the Boys and Girls Club.
Right, it's the third weekend
That's
of
this
September.
Saturday.
So it is this Saturday.
It's this Saturday is Boys and Girls Club.
Yeah, and
national.
For an example, I love to dance, and I have not danced since I hurt my leg. I have been practicing now because I am teaching a class.
She's on the line now.
But I went and found somewhere, and I said, hey, would you like to have somebody that would love to dance with me? And so we're doing a line, you know, well, it's kind of dance team, but just find things that bring you joy. When you look
yes.
at your calendar, if you don't love your job, I can't really change that, nor can anybody else, only you can.
You can, yeah.
Until you can change that, until
right.
you're at that process, take the sunshine message and put in those little spots of free time instead of looking at all the home things that you might be sad about
right.
or scrolling or whatever. Schedule a fun event. One.
Right.
Just one. And watch the people evolve.
Right.
Watch. I'm not going to say true love because that would make a promise.
Well, yeah, no.
But I'll say true like. And a lot more fun.
Yeah, I think you have I think you have more fun than you want then. But, you know, and two, you know, do what she's telling you to do and try to remember to share that with somebody and volunteer at
sure.
school or well, what the mentoring program we're doing or with the Boys and Girls Club or Girls Inc. And there's so many nonprofits that need help and they make such a big impact on the
sure.
community. And you'll find somebody there too. So,
right.
You know.
You know, it works. Okay,
it does.
We're moving on. So we hope that you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. Don't forget to check the weather out.
Oh, yes.
Listen.
We've got some amazing people doing the
weather. Oh, we do. So. WLKY is doing a fabulous job, yeah. and Debbie is working with them, and every weekend they give you the weather for your fun events that we just talked about.
Yep.
All those people, they'll be there. If you love crafts, I'm sure you have a craft place. Come on now. There's a craft play. You know, if you love bacon, go to Bacon and Blues.
Oh.
I don't care where you go. Don't go stand in the corner, though. Okay?
Right.
WLKY is giving you good weather.
That's right.
At least reliable weather.
Yeah, it is reliable. Oh, that's
it
a good
It is very
one.
Reliable.
Yeah, very. But, you know, you need to remember that all of these festivals, there are so many of them that we can't cover them all. But we try to pick two that are not very well known sometimes.
Sure.
Sometimes it's a real
popular
one.
Get a little more
one.
Publicity.
Yeah, because they have worked just as hard to put that event together as all the others have.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes there's different categories, the reasons why we choose the ones we
right.
do. But there's always a reason, and we have several questions we ask ourselves about these events, you know, and we go through those, and then we choose two events, one from Indiana and one from Kentucky, and Jay Cardosi or Tiffany Savona. And they're both great. They go on and talk about the weather for that event. And
this
the
is
weekend.
The whole region. It's not just
yeah.
Madison or Trimble County.
It's everything between
area.
Scottsburg and down to Crestwood and Switzerland County over to Clarksville. So we try to cover that many
Keeps
counties.
You kind of focused on your area and
yeah.
where you might want to plan
yeah.
your fun.
And that's where most of us travel. If we live in this area, that's our travel.
Sure. Except for me.
Yep.
I'm going to be in California, Nashville.
She just pops in
next
everywhere.
Next month.
So.
I'm so excited. I'll tell you guys all about it.
Hopefully
we're doing
she'll
great
take
things.
A picture or two.
I'll take lots of pictures.
Okay.
I'm so excited. Can't tell you everything that's going on. I do have to shout out Marcy. Mm-hmm.
Marcy Dunn.
She is watching us. And I know you guys might have heard this on the Facebook, The Real Coffee Top last
But she
week.
Doesn't have Facebook, so we have to do this.
Yes, I think so. She's only Channel 15,
right.
maybe. But if not...
Right.
Still, whatever. Make sure that you understand. We will shout you out. We really will. We'd love to have you come on here and tell us about your business. We would love to create something
oh, yeah.
for you. We love people. That's why we do this. As always, we're so happy that you're here with us and that you're enjoying watching. We have a great month scheduled for you. We have a great, actually, we have the finish of 2018 pretty much scheduled, but we will still take your suggestions. Yeah. We'd love to hear from you. Send us a letter, Sunshine Messages, 173, Post Office Box 173, Milton, Kentucky, 40045, or contact us on The Real Coffee Talk.
Or Bridging the Gap Productions.
Any of those.
Yep.
Well, we just have fun. So, anybody want to come along? We'd also love to shout you out.
Well, as always, we thank you for watching.